So there won't be nobody here? It's not right for the day.
You can't sit there and do that, Miss Bam?
It's gonna be a ghost broadcast today. Ghost protocol.
Really? You said ghost? A ghost?
Yes. The ghost of relationships past.
Oh no.
You said you was doing, what you looking for, honey? Tequila in the house! I took mine out. Anyway, let us know where you from. What set you claiming? Miss Brooks, how you doing? Hello.
What's
that? Hmm? You worrying about the wrong thing. Hello, everyone's. Mohair art. Today, or this evening, we're going to talk about in-laws and how we really love them and everything like that.
Man, move out. I'm still in a hump. Ow!
It's too far away. What you going to do on this one?
I ain't got that yet. All right, so we're building. We're blending. Hey, everybody, come on in the room. We don't know much about Instagram Live. We only did it for the first time last week. Hey, so we're on Facebook Live and Instagram Live. So thank you. This is a half roll. This is a two-strand twist with a roll at the end. This is some rigging. Late in the midnight hour. So, we, as you know, we have a post that we put up, and I'm gonna try to keep putting it up, but we're asking for people to say things that they want us to talk about, like the topic about sex. What was it? Why married women don't have sex? That came from you guys.
Right.
So, hey, Delona. So what we need is for you guys to continually put topics and posts out. I have a few topics that that was suggested, and they're good. Some of them we have to find a way to not be specific to the person and be more general in things that we see that other couples go through, so it won't just be one person. So
don't forget to share.
Yeah, if you get it, take a minute on, I know Facebook Live, on the left-hand side, click the share button and share it to your page so we can tell your friends that we're live. For some reason, the post that I made this week said that we were in Central Standard Time, so it has us coming on at 9 local time. Our time. So I wasn't able to, I was unable to fix it, but oh well. So if you can tell me where you're from, if we don't already know, but we are in Orlando, and if you have looked at the news at all, you see that Orlando has been in an uproar all day. It's been like a dark cloud over us. I must say it has been a rough day. Anybody that's in Orlando have felt heavy and down and unbelievable, all the other good stuff. But that being said, I know that a lot of times it's just like life. Our circumstances are not the best. Sometimes life brings you not lemons, but it brings you just straight crap. Right. And honestly, you can't change what happens in your life, but your attitude and your demeanor and how you are to people is the only thing that you can change. That girl said, I'm from Orlando. So silly. Coco, you know what?
Washington, D.C.
Oklahoma, Raleigh. Good. So, you know, keep Orlando in your prayers. The officer that was killed today is a young black lady, and she has been married, just celebrated her 1-year wedding anniversary. So that's always heartbreaking because we're married. We know that at any point in time, it could be... At any point in time, it could be us. And so even before we get started, one of the important things I think that we need to say and reiterate is not to take your spouse for granted. We leave in the morning and you just assume at night, your spouse say, I'll be home at 5, I'll be home at 6, I'm getting off early. But what happens if they don't get off early? What happens if they don't make it back home? So is the stuff that you're fussing about, is the stuff that's going on in your life, is it worth it? So just take a moment to love on your spouse, love on your family, pray for your spouse, cover your family. I mean, I do it every morning, but today I was just like, I know that man thought his wife was coming home today. They just celebrated university. Even though she works in law enforcement, she's been doing that for 17 years. He had no idea. And then another officer that was trying to help look for the guy and secure the perimeter, he got hit by a car and dies. Another black man. You just don't know when your time is. We plan our lives, but you never know when your time is. So hug your family, hug your children, hug your spouse tight, and realize that some things are just not too important enough to fuss about.
Right.
So if you can, again, we're doing Facebook Live and Instagram Live. Instagram Live is new. Hey, if you could share, we haven't really gotten into the topic yet, but just share it to your page. Hey, Jay. Okay. So we can, we try to give people time to get into the room, especially since the time on Facebook Live is not right today. But share it to your page. I greatly appreciate it. So as my husband said, the topic that was suggested and that one of the many that we'll be getting into is about in-laws. And in-laws could be the best thing or the worst thing, just like marriage. Right?
Yeah.
So, but...
What's up, Shante?
Oh, hey, Shante. But, you know, the other part of that, too, is before we get started on that, I've uploaded those videos from previous broadcasts. I haven't finished all of them, but a lot of them are up on our Black Love United YouTube page. You know, I would appreciate you guys subscribing to our page, liking our page, right. Like this page, subscribe to it.
You can go back and watch all the videos.
And we have different topics. YouTube. I actually had to go back and write the topics in because sometimes I was just writing live. Hey! I was just writing live with Ced and Angie, but I wasn't putting a topic. So I had to go back and write the topic in there. Hey, Monique.
Right.
So that people can have, like, if you're going through something, a lot of the stuff we've covered, like, we did cover in-laws a little bit before, but it wasn't just a show about in-laws, right?
Correct.
All right.
We touched on it briefly.
All right. So, again, if you can, share to your page so we can get follows up. Last week, we got, before Facebook started acting up, and just to tell you, last week when we were having all the difficulties, it wasn't our Wi-Fi. Facebook was having problems. They were merging videos and comments were merging on others. We had gotten up to like 550 people. Like, we have people watching these, like 2,000 people, later. But on the actual broadcast, we had got to like 550 watching that. So that's from your shares, from your likes. I greatly appreciate that. Right. Hey, Q.
What's going on?
So, you would, how we want to start out about in-laws? Are you laughing? He's been talking personal. Can he be nice before we get started being mean?
I'm not going to talk anything. Oh, no. Shantae said it was 600.
Oh, but look, Shantae, we got, was it like 3 million views or something like that? Not 3 million. It was 1 million.
I don't
know. It was a million on that particular broadcast. So it was great. I mean, I just want, we want to help marriages. And so helping marriages is not always just the, oh, yeah, 1.2 million. Thanks, Keela. Because I sent it to her. I was like, do you see this? So, you know, the only way we do that is that because our friends are not your friends. So when you share it to your timelines that are going on, people say, I want to see what they're talking about. Sometimes Right. They just click on it. Some people say, some people don't. But the fact that they get to see that we're there, and if we grab their attention, then they come back and they see us. So we definitely appreciate the hearts, the likes. We appreciate the Instagram live followers. So when you said, I missed you last week. Happy New Year. Jay, you got to go look. Look at one from last week, yeah. Really.
And YouTube, they all on YouTube.
Facebook had some problems last week, but we had, somebody said 600 at one point, but I know I saw 550 at one, 552 or something like that. So, tonight we're talking about in-laws. I don't know how many of you have had in-law problems.
Well, there was a movie once called Monster-in-Law.
And my mother-in-law get mad at me when I say this, but I told her that was her when I first married my husband. She was monster-in-law. Because in that movie, I can't remember who was playing the wife, but the mother...
The wife was Jennifer Lopez. When,
I know, but the mother was doing mean stuff behind her son's back because she didn't want to seem like she was being... She didn't like her, but she didn't really have a reason, so she just... did stuff to try to sabotage her. In this movie, she tried to poison her and do all kind of crazy stuff to her. So, did you look?
Yeah, she says blurry or something. Let me get something.
Which one is blurry? Okay, hold on. Chad, we have people that love to text us during the broadcast, and they say it was blurry. Is that better? I had a tissue in my hand. Is that better, or is it the lighting? I can't tell. These cameras are so different. So anyway, she didn't say, but it looks better. In the movie, it's fine, baby. It's fine, baby. It's fine. I just did that.
You didn't have this though.
I don't care what I had.
Yeah, it's not a napkin.
It was not a snotty napkin. I'm not gonna put snotty napkins on my phone.
That's right.
He gonna get a whooping. Okay, Keely, you gotta text him by himself because you keep messing up the camera. I can't see. I gotta exit.
See, she said it was better until I wiped it. That's better.
When you she did not say that.
When you did, she said it was still messed up.
Anyway, all right. Thank you for saying it's better, and I appreciate the feedback. So it would say, can you do a topic about equality of finances and how to divide funds at the bills? Okay, so I have a post on the page, you need to put it under there because I'm not going to remember this broadcast when it's over, girl. I would have to go back and watch this whole thing. So any topic that you are interested in us doing, put it underneath that particular picture. And I'll post another one tonight so that we can get the comments so we can get it going.
Jay, do that as well because you had a very good topic too. So
what did she say?
She was saying about wearing the wedding ring, to wear or not to wear.
Ooh. Yeah, that is really a good one. We had that question asked us before, and it was, but you gotta get in the camera for this one somewhat. So
just angle the computer.
So we
there you go.
So we haven't really touched on it as much, but those things, everything I believe has some underlying issue. Those are just symptoms of a problem. Right? All right.
Lonnie. What's up, Lonnie?
Okay, so in-laws. The main thing that I hear, and when the person posted about in-laws, any time you ask me a topic, I may ask you what specifically about that. Because like you just said, in-laws, okay, what about in-laws?
Right.
And they were talking about your spouse telling the in-laws the problems and what's going on. What do you say about that, babe?
About telling in-laws problems? That That's difficult. I know a lot of people are used to talking to their parents about different things, but once you get married, we recommend that you find somebody besides parents to talk to about your problem, because number one, your parents are usually not very good at being unbiased because you're their baby.
Right.
And number two, once you get over the situation and come to a resolution, your parents are still upset with that person about whatever you told them went on. So it's a good practice to find somebody other than parents to, you know.
Now, you can have parents that's not biased.
Right.
However,
that's an exception, not the rule.
That's an exception, not the rule. And just because, Sean, will you press off on the timer, please? Not debate, but off on the timer, okay? Yeah. All right. So the problem is, we tend to, you know, when you will get into it with your spouse, you mad with them.
Right.
And you want somebody that's going to take your side. You want somebody that's going to make you feel better about what's going on. And so your parents, your mother especially, is the one that's usually like, you know, baby, she don't know how to treat you, or he don't know how to do whatever. And they kind of nurture you. But a lot of times, your mother is the reason why you are the way you are. And you are
whatever the case may be.
Right. I was going to say stable. I'm not stable. What's it called? Stunned. Your growth is stunted in that area.
Right.
Because, you know, we like to see the best in our children, but we don't always see the truth in what's going on.
Right.
And so, what you said about finding somebody. And if you have some more topics or questions about this as you talk, you can post a question. We can keep going. Boundaries are definitely important. Now, what?
Mo says, yes, and looking at you sideways, and it also makes you feel uncomfortable when you're around the in-laws.
Right. Well, okay, so before we go to boundaries, go there. So I tell my mama that Cedric did whatever and said whatever, and then we kiss and make up, or hunch and make up, or whatever we do, whatever y'all do. And then y'all are lovey-dovey, and you go to a family function, and everybody acting stank. Because even if they don't say anything, you feel the tension. Just like if you ever walk in the house and a husband, wife, and fussing, you feel it. You don't know what's going on. They can smile. You be like, mm-mm, something ain't right. Right?
That's correct. Feel the tension.
But you can't just be amen in the night. You got to talk. That is correct. Amen.
I started off. What are you talking about?
Why you finding out?
About that foolishness this evening.
What you going to do? What you going to do?
Hold on, let me turn the camera.
Baby. Right. So it's important that you find, first of all, I think that when you're having problems, you need to find someone that is going to tell you the truth. We want our friends, and even if your friends are married, they're not usually the best person to go to. Because a lot of times your friend gonna tell you what you want to hear, or what's based upon what their marriage is going through. Like, I know people that have marriages where they're just roommates. Well, they don't understand hanging out with your spouse, or being with your spouse, or having fun with them, or being friends, because that's not what they experience. Or if they're married and they're miserable, their advice is not going to be anything uplifting or stay in it. Stick with it. You can make it through there. And so it is important that you find, and I say a couple is always good, because, you know, it's I want to say a balance.
Right. Well, they can understand what you're going through, because everybody that's married has been through some ups and downs and situations.
Well, I'm saying, so what's the difference if I just talk to the wife or I talk to the husband, as opposed to talking to them together?
Because you want
to
get both points of view, because the wife, she's going to tell you the best that she can, but that'll be only from the wife's point of view. You want to hear what's going on from the husband's point of view, because you're in relationship with your husband or with your wife, or whatever the case may be.
Right. Now, let me throw a little, we talking about telling your mother and your father about your situation, but I'm going to go a little further and say it is definitely off limits, and out of bounds to talk to your children about your problems, about what your husband or wife are not doing. I know many couples that confide in their children if they're having problems with the husband or the wife. But what that does is that, and I'm not even talking about blended family children, I'm talking about your own children, you still put too much pressure on that child. Because that's not, a child should be not be worried about whether you and daddy gonna divorce, because they see that all the time. So then you just think y'all had a fight and y'all made up and y'all going on. That child is like, my mom and dad gonna get divorced. Because at that time, that fight, that argument seems huge. Seems like we can't make it. I mean, we done had disagreements that I felt like I didn't see how we could ever get past it, because I just thought it was just the end all, because he felt one way, I felt one way, I said my point, he wasn't hearing me, he wasn't listening to me, he didn't understand me, and I didn't understand him, and I felt like he was being stubborn. And so had I told my children at that time what I was feeling, it would have been exaggerated, it would have been full of emotion, and when we made up, when they leave, those kids are still calculating what's going on. And you're not married to the children. You parent the children. So they're not your friend. You can be cool with your kids, but they're not your friend. So they should not know when daddy didn't come home. I'm not saying if he don't come to the house, they don't see it. But I'm like, if he ain't come home by the time you think, you know, you can have disagreements. Kids can see you not always getting along. But when he walk in the door, you shouldn't be start yelling and cussing at him when you walk in the door in front of your children. You shouldn't be cussing anyway at each other. That's just what I'm going to say. You need to use other words than cursing. I want to say that.
What's up, Eunice? Via Davis on Instagram says, children will pick sides. And that's normally if they're put into the middle of it. If they don't know anything that's going on, they generally won't pick sides.
And the kids will ask you, are you okay, too? I mean, and you could say, you know, it's okay to say, you know, it's just mom's having a rough day, or we having a rough day, you know, whatever. But to be telling details to a child is out of bounds. And it's not, adults don't do that. Not adults, not parents, not real adults.
Right.
Children do that. Children go tell other children because they don't really care about or don't know about the consequences. Adults, you know the consequences of that, and you know the long-term effects of that, so you do not, and you should not, tell your children what is going on between you and your spouse, just like your parents. Now we talk.
I'm sorry. Kita says it messes with the kids why they can't do their schoolwork because they're worrying about mom and dad.
And that's true. And I don't know if you, yeah, I mean, we see movies all the time. But those movies, a lot of stuff in that movie come from real life. Because, you know, something is a simple argument to you to realize. You and him might argue all the time, and nobody ever knows it. But then once you open that door and tell that child about your whatever you had going on or whoever fussing and fighting, and then every time they hear anything or they see something going on, they think, oh, they're going to get a divorce. You know, and they don't know how to compartmentalize, I guess it was. But they shouldn't have to. That's not their... They should be worried about their schoolwork.
Well, they don't have the emotional tools to deal with that yet.
Well, heck, half the adults don't have the emotional tools to deal with marriage.
Correct.
Truth be told, when we get married, a lot of us, most of us, are emotionally jacked up from something. From parenting, from step-parents, from school, from an employer, from something that's happening. We get married, we are emotionally messed up. Whether you've been, you know, molested, neglected, whether you were homeless, whatever your problems that you brought, you bring that stuff to your marriage, unless you just get some serious deliverance. And usually there's still some remnants later on. Right.
Maria says that she usually talks to couples in her marriage class at church, which that's good, but one thing I would advise against concerning that is I wouldn't tell too many intimate details to too many couples. I would narrow it down to one or two max, because you don't want too many chefs in the kitchen, so you'd be getting too many different forms of advice.
I would say, Maria, first of all, whoever's over your marriage ministry, if you trust and believe what they are teaching you, then I would ask that you go to them. Because whoever put them over it obviously felt like they had some knowledge and some wisdom in that area. And then that limits, because usually when you're a leader, you have a level of accountability, you have a level of privacy, things of that nature. You just don't talk. But when it's somebody else, you know how it is. You tell one person and they tell somebody else, well, that's, I mean, they might not even mean to be messy. They just are. And they, and it can just have a bad effect, because if you tell a couple people and then those people talk, oh, they talk to you, then they see somebody else, they talk to you, and then you just don't have a way of, you, because everybody's household is run differently. But biblical principles work regardless.
Jay says, what happens if your spouse tells everyone else your problems and you're looking crazy because you didn't know you had problems? I know it's a communication breakdown, but they deny doing it.
Ooh.
It's a lot going on right there.
So what are you saying?
I don't know what to say to that. I mean, there's a lot of variables that goes into that. I mean,
I'm saying, but just what with that, where would you tell her to start?
I don't know, because she says that she didn't know there was a problem. That in and of itself is a whole another line of questioning.
Yeah, Jay, and I'm not doubting you that you didn't know it was a problem. I just find it difficult to believe that it wasn't expressed, just maybe not the way we would express it. Like, Cedric had some things that he didn't like. And it was, he made little comments or little jabs, but they weren't like, he didn't sit and have a conversation. He didn't tell me I hurt his feelings. He didn't tell me this and that. But when it came down, he had been saying stuff all along. I just didn't catch it because I was too busy and I wasn't paying attention to him. I hadn't spent that intimate time to get to know him. So I think that majority of men will say things, they just don't be, they don't like, you hurt my feelings, or you did this, they be like, all right, y'all's on their phone, and they'll keep watching their game. You know, they say little stuff, oh, you got time for everybody else, you got time for me, they might even laugh. But if it's something that he's saying consistently, that, even if it's like in laughter, might want to check that.
Right. Shante just made a comment saying that her parents never involved her in arguments, she thought they never fought. She said she liked that.
Well, Shante, that's a negative thing as well.
Right.
My parents have been married now for going on 56 years, and I never saw my mom and dad hug and kiss, and I never saw them fuss and fight. But what that did is when I got married, because Cedric is not my first marriage, when I got married and we didn't get along and everything wasn't perfect, I thought that something was wrong with me or with him. But because I didn't realize that part of marriage is disagreements. It is getting to know one another. It is love and affection. You know, there's a balance. And so your children should see, like, if it sounds like he's made me mad. Now, I'm not calling him names. I'm still respectful to him. And they know that I'm not happy with him, or I'm upset with him by my actions or me not really saying anything. But then they see him hugging and kissing me, and we playing around and we dancing around the house. They see the balance. They have to see the balance. The balance is about, topic is about in-laws. We're talking about in-laws, but right now we're talking about sharing, not involving your children in your drama, your dilemma, your arguments.
Issues,
they're talking about being careful who you share with. So, all right, so you have something else?
Yeah, next one is, what if the in-laws pull him or her to the side and talk about the other person behind their back?
Okay, well, first of all, whoever is getting pulled should check that. If my mom pulled me to the side to talk about Cedric, it's not happening. I mean, now, if they call and say, I'm concerned because he's beating you, or, you know, I feel like you're getting abused, I'm not saying anything like that, you know, but I'm talking about, you know, they don't like the way you do this, or you do this, you do that. You need to check that. If you don't check it, you are the wrong party in that. Because there's no way that somebody going to come talk to me about my husband. Now, it could be the truth. But you won't know that. We ain't finna have that conversation. Now, I can talk about him to him, but he ain't gonna... you ain't finna talk about him. What do you think about... Well, I mean, what's your comment on that?
I agree. I mean, if you let it continue to go on, just like anything else, they'll keep doing it. So you have to put a stop to it.
But that's like friends. If you got a friend that always call you, every time they call you, girl, you heard that such and such marriage going down too, or you heard that such and such left such and such, a girl, da 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 da. you are then the garbage can, because all you're doing is getting dumped trash.
Into.
I mean, just dumped, period. Like, it's just, it's nothing good. Now, you're going to have, you should have a balance in any relationship. So, you have to put a stop to it. What are you worth? Are you garbage? Because, if I mean, if you're a garbage can, then that's what you get. But if you consider yourself a vessel, something special and something unique, then you're not going to allow people to put crap. Just like, you got a house, you ain't going to let nobody come. You know how people dump their trash at the end of the week? Well, I'm not going to put it on the curb. I'm just going to come dump it in your house. Every day, I just have to go throw it in the middle of your floor. Why would you not do that? Because you value your house. You want your house clean. That should be the same thing for you, your vessel, your body, and your marriage. I want it clean, so don't bring me that crap.
Right. Stephanie says, what about... she says in-laws, but she's not mean. Not the mother, father, but sisters or brothers of spouses having a say-so in your relationship.
No one should have a say-so in your relationship but you, your spouse, and God. That's it. There are no other variables for that. It doesn't mean that you can't have somebody that you confide in or somebody that you consult that's going to give you balance and godly wisdom. I'm not talking about that. But even in, like, we have couples that we help. But even in us helping couples, we're telling them godly principles, things that work. They have to apply that in order for it to work.
Right.
We don't, and that's the thing. When couples come, they want a magic wand. No, I can give you all the tools, but if you don't do them, it doesn't work.
Right.
And just like if you were hungry, Cedric would say he's hungry. I can fix him a feast. If he doesn't eat, he still can starve to death. So you have to do the work. It is no magic wand for marriage. It's actually crappy at times, but then it's the best thing at times. Just like anything else. You don't have perfect... You're not on the mountaintop all the time.
Right. There's peaks and valleys.
But you appreciate the peaks when you've been in that valley.
Exactly. And you want to try to shorten that valley time as much as you can.
Right. And you said about him having siblings that are...
Sisters and brothers.
Sisters and brothers. Yeah. It's the same thing we told you about stopping it. Okay, so, and this is a rule that we learned a long time ago. We took a class at one of our church. It was Relationship 101. They had relationship, like, different series. We took them all. At that time, we couldn't stand each other. We thought we weren't going to be together about 10 more seconds. But we made it. And God had a purpose. But Relationships 101 told us that whoever family member that it is, that's the one who addresses it. So, for instance, in the beginning... his mother had some stuff that she didn't particularly care for me, and my mom wasn't a fan of his. So if my mom did something, I had to say something to my mother. Why? It's because, okay, I said something to my mother because my mom loves me, like we said earlier. So even if she don't like my decision or she doesn't like what's going on, she's still gonna love me. She can end up hating him because he always got something to say to her. Well, but I need to tell her, Mom, that's my husband, right. And we got this. Well, we're going to pray about it. Yes, we're going through some hard times. We're going to make it. So the other side of that, when his mama did something, he had to say, Mom, you know, that's not cool. That can't happen. And I'm telling you, that's the one thing that I never felt like was lacking. He wouldn't let anybody do anything to me. He doesn't have the issue that a lot of couples, a lot of men have and a lot of women have in that area where you would say that. They were like, oh, he won't stand up for me. He wouldn't, even if he didn't agree with me, he like, Mom, we not doing that. It was just like point blank.
That boy did it.
What talk? So read some ass. What is going on?
Maria says, I think some parents, including my mom, don't understand the importance of leaving and cleaving, or they do, and that's why they interfere with marriages.
Well, they could understand, but the motherly side of them or the parental side of them still want to kick in. The parental side want to still say, hey, you know, that's my baby. I want to help. I want to do this. I don't think you should do this. I don't think you should do that. But that's a part of being an adult. You got to check them. But this is the key. You got to check them every time.
Right.
If you let them talk about them sometime when you're mad and they can't talk about another time, then it sends mixed messages. They gotta know that you're a team.
Right.
Teams don't always agree. But when we win the championship, we all got a ring. That's just how it works. So
Jay says she had that happen to her. Spouse didn't stand up for her. She had to confront the family member, and the spouse didn't want to be in the middle of the situation. Keita says that, yes, they have to take up for you, because if not, it gets worse.
It does.
Terry says, what about the in-laws that tell you how to raise your kids? How do you deal with that?
Well, let's start first, because Jay says she had it happen. All right, so Jay, your husband got to get his balls up. You know I'm 100% direct. There is no way that your husband said to my didn't want to be involved. Because if that's your family and they're making your spouse uncomfortable, you got to fix that. You can't change them, but you can fix those boundaries. And sometimes you have to say, you know what? If you can't treat my spouse the way they did, then we won't be coming. And if they love you, they're going to either adapt to it.
Or fake like they adapt to it.
They not going to... If you saying that we're not coming, if you don't know how to act or treat my wife or treat my husband, it'll change some things.
Right.
Or you'll start your own space. It's sometimes uncomfortable, but it can work. It will work. But you have to be consistent.
Right. You have to be committed to it.
And what was the next one? Keila said something about it will get worse.
It'll get worse. Yeah.
Right. Mm-hmm. If you don't, but that's with anything. When you have underlying issues in your marriage, period, if you don't address it, it will come back and address you. And usually when it addresses you, it's not at a convenient time.
Well, the thing about that, if it's just like a cycle. If you don't address the problem, it keeps happening over and over and over again. And that's where resentment and hatred come from in a relationship.
Well, you know, if you everybody that's married, if you think about your marriage, you can pick one thing out of your marriage right now that you have had to deal with
over and over.
All throughout your years. I don't care if you've been married 5 years, 10 years, 20 years. You might have had 10 things in the beginning, but right now you might just have two. But there's something that even though you get past those hurdles, it come back every 6 months, every year, every how often. Everybody has something like that.
Right.
And it's different for everybody. We still have stuff that's like that, but it's easier now. We have the tools to learn how to deal with stuff now, and we've worked through some things now. But we still have some of the same issues that will come back and bite you in the butt.
Well, we have a open line of communication that we know how to disagree amicably.
Without calling names.
Right.
Cussing each other out. Saying you stupid, your mama stupid, everybody's stupid. And that's why your family dumb, your whole family dumb.
Oh, Lord.
But you know that's what they do. But you got to learn how to...
Right. We went through that phase early on.
No, we didn't. You did.
No,
you've always been a name caller.
No, you.
My husband was he. Okay, so my husband has a very extensive vocabulary.
Choice words my wife had.
He has an extensive vocabulary, and what he would do was say a whole bunch of big words that nobody in their right mind ever heard of, and so he would do that because I was like, "What?" So I had to take what he said and figure out what it meant. But then he would do it on purpose, and I was like. And I was like, what does that mean? He was like, well, you know, if you get your mind game up or something like that, like, get smarter. You would know what I'm saying, you know. Do I shut the dummy myself down for you? My husband. God has brought him a mad, mad, mad long way. Why are you laughing? Y'all see he ain't disagreeing. But he done came a long way.
Yeah, wisdom. Sometimes you just have to let people talk.
Can you cut the oven off, please?
Raising the kids. You can get it out.
All right, so what was the thing?
The in-laws that tell you how to raise kids. How do you deal with that was the question.
All right, so the raising the kids is the same thing as we talked about your marriage. Boundaries. It doesn't mean that you can't take input.
Advice.
But again, you know, we talked about relationships and intimacy. If you don't have an intimate relationship with your in-laws, they can't come tell you how to raise your kids because I got this. I don't need none of you because you don't like them. They don't like you. Y'all just dealing because y'all got y'all married. But even when you do like them, you might not agree.
Well, but not only that, it's still different because when you live in a house with a kid every day, it's different than when you see a kid on occasion. Even if you see them like every few days or every week. Still different than living with a kid, that you don't have the same working knowledge of the child. to be able to, you know what they need discipline-wise, love-wise, attention-wise, whatever the case may be.
Right. What did Lona say?
KMSL? I don't know what that means. I'm not up on the tech stuff.
Me either. So, Merry Christmas. What's it? Oh, Mama Cher, you have...
Are you on here? Laugh out loud.
You know what? Well, you know the thing about it is that you could always tag people in this and share it and mysteriously talk it, post to your page. Like, I like this about in-laws.
Oh, you can tie them to the chair and make them watch it.
No, did you say tie them to the chair and make them watch it?
Don't do that.
That's called kidnapping.
Yeah, don't do that.
Yeah, you go to jail for that. And I'm sure some situations.
If they're already sitting in the chair, it's not kidnapping because you didn't move them.
If you said tie them, if they're unable to go on their own free will, it's kidnapping.
What if you just put some Velcro on the chair and they sit on the Velcro and they can't move?
I digress.
Anyway, we had another one that I thought you would really find interesting. She said, what about those in-laws that are friends with your spouse's ex?
Oh, my.
And the in-law always give report statuses on your relationship. How can you attempt to build a relationship with those in-laws?
Ooh. So, once again, we do disclaimers. These are... Some of them are principles, things we've learned, but some of them are our opinions as well from what we've learned over the years. So there's not we don't have a Bible, say the Angie Bible. But
that's a different situation there.
Yes. So I mean, there is not a rule that say that
your in-laws can't be
friends or still like the ex.
Correct.
Because, you know, truth be told, people break up and you still cool with that person. They were nice to you. You didn't have the issues, whatever the case may be.
Right.
Especially when you have children. Right. Leave it. When you have children involved and your child marries somebody else and then you still like the mother. Like, I don't personally believe that when you have, like, family reunions, all the exes should be there with the kids. If it's a family reunion, then the children come with the parent that whose family that is. Because it just leads for just so much
It's messy, it's uncomfortable.
Yeah. And it goes also to motive. Why is the mother here? Why is the father here?
She got the seed.
Yeah, I understand that, but
I'm saying that's what they would say. I'm sure.
Okay, but then if you got 10 seeds from 10 different women, so all of them are there. All of them are.
That's a lot of seeds.
But I'm just that said. And so, what she said? What Jay say?
Laugh out loud. But the comment about Mama Cheryl, she on there. She said Cheryl Dukes is her mother-in-law.
Nuh-uh.
Yes, that. So she knew she was on there, I guess.
Well, okay, so we got Facebook Live and we have Instagram Live. So also on Facebook, if you can go ahead and share to your page if you haven't already done it on the left-hand side for people to join. So we talk about, you said Mom Dukes is the mother-in-law. That's funny. Well,
yes, that's what's called a gray area.
It's a gray area.
Yeah.
But also, that's an area that your spouse would have to feel that was not appropriate to talk to his family about.
Right. Well, but at the end of the day, it's still the in-law's decision. But what I would say is, you know, I wouldn't focus a lot of energy on that. You control what you can control. And, you know, go from there. Because, over time, those things tend to work themselves out because...
No, they don't. You
know, not always.
They do not.
Sometimes they do.
If it's not addressed, they don't. It don't just go away. If your mother-in-law is messy, she is messy.
No, but I'm saying, how do you address that? If she's having conversations with the ex, you can't say, Mama, you can't talk to them.
No, but so if your mom was still talking to your ex and doing whatever, and, you know, you expressed to her that, Mama, I know you cool with... such and such. But, you know, a marriage is uncomfortable and it's not, you know, the best situation for my marriage to move forward.
But that would only be with situations where you were going to be around or something like that. I couldn't say you can't be friends with that person.
No, but it was saying that, you know, they were still communicating, they were still hanging. Like, I know, but you wouldn't, I'm saying, but to tell your mother that your constant communication with my ex, I mean, you're not telling them to hate that person or not to talk to them at all, but you wouldn't be given blow by blow. Another reason why
you don't tell your
another reason why your mother-in-law shouldn't know your business, because if they don't know it, they can't tell it.
Exactly.
All they know is they married and they together. They can't know nothing if you ain't told them or if he ain't telling them.
And everything they tell them will be speculation.
Say, love what you guys are doing. Hope there is a replay. Let me know. Okay, so for Instagram Live, we don't have but a couple followers that come on here. This is our second week doing this. We're on Facebook Live. And so on Facebook Live, of course, when we finish, the whole post is there. We have one every Monday night. And then we also now are uploading the videos to our YouTube channel, which is Black Love United. So between either Facebook Live or Black Love United, you can go back and watch them.
And Black Love United is what we are on everything.
Right.
Instagram, Facebook, website, YouTube.
Oh, nah. He doesn't know social media. So he was struggling right then. You see the website, the Twitter.
Shout out to everybody still on MySpace.
What? Did you say MySpace? He is dumb. All right. So, yeah, it says I'm a good mother-in-law. Are you, Cheryl?
Yeah, I think she is.
Well, that's cool though. That's, you know, awesome, Mama Cheryl. You know, and this is my testimony moment, okay? So my mother-in-law, my husband is her baby. My husband has a bunch of brothers and sisters by his dad, but there was only two of them. He has an older sister and him. This was her date to all the events. This was her breakfast day. I love my daughter-in-law. This was her everything. So then this heifer comes into the picture. And I wasn't her first choice.
Or second or third.
That's not nice. What choice was I, babe?
I don't know. 11, 12, 15, something down there. 20 maybe, I don't know.
Y'all gonna let him talk about me like that? Way That's so not there. Nice. So anyway, but we had a many of uncomfortable holidays. A many holidays I cried. A many holidays I was just like, oh my God, I don't even want to go. Had bubble guts all night because I got to go over here and deal with your people.
Our time over there was short though. We used to have it in a long time.
It wasn't long to him, but it was long to me. When you over there in a place where you know people don't like you, because she ain't like me, you know,
the rest of the crew.
The rest of the crew was kind of like, or if they was having a conversation, everybody was chiming in. If I say something, they're like, I ain't saying nothing. Yeah, such and such. They was like, all right, then, but you know what I'm saying? So y'all ain't hear me? Y'all ain't hear what I said? Y'all ain't hear me talk?
Straight ignore it.
Okay, if I was to start tripping, they'd be like, see, I told you you're crazy. So now I'm like, y'all hear me? But out of the gasket. So I digress. I went back. Okay. So what I did, we had some different things that happened, but one day I had a talk with her and I said, you know, there's really enough love for you and I both to love him. We don't have to fight over him. I'm not trying to take him from his mother. I just want to be his wife. And, you know, it didn't happen all of a sudden, but then I began to pray about that thing. I've been praying for a while, but I really began to pray about that. And I really didn't see how it could get better, honestly. But I did tear it. Yeah. And now my mother-in-law and I have the best relationship. So much so that this guy, not saying any names, this gets jealous because she'll make me certain things that I like. She'll cook it for me. And you
get jealous.
You done made that heifer her dish about three times. I ain't had such and such in months. Oh, he's so used to her catering to him that now that she does for me or she'll make something for me, he's salty.
Right.
So when I tell you that God and prayer changes things.
Okay, see, now you testify. I'm going to testify too now.
But testify then, baby.
Every time she make them beans, and I bring them here, I put my toes in them before I bring them home. Every time you eat toe jams.
Like, I go get it myself.
You like, boy, your mom put her feet in these long. These are my feet. Put my feet all in them. It's probably salt and everything in the beans.
Whatever.
Yeah, I stir them up with my toes.
But just know that there, people tend to think that when you have a horrible relationship with your in-laws, and I'm saying it was horrible because that's how I felt at the time. You know, and she did little stuff that she didn't do around him. She was doing it.
Don't you do that.
Oh my God, she was doing stuff. She I was like, Ted, you said, he was like, I ain't see that. I was like, for real, you ain't.
I did. Ted,
she said, you ain't.
And I asked her about it later. She said, I didn't say that. She tripping. Oh, what's wrong with her? I said, I don't know, mama.
So until the time that she said, I just called in. She hung up on me. And you said, mama, I was sitting right here. She did not hang up on you. But he did tell her. But I'm telling you, had he not been sitting there, it would have been, see, you hang up on my mama, da 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 da. So, anyway, thank you, Cheryl. But I'm just telling you that God answers prayers.
You were mistreating my mama. That's what it was.
I mean, I wanted to push your mama down. I couldn't because you love your mama, but I wanted to. I wanted to push her, kick her, everything. I just felt like she was
not the Lord.
It wasn't the Lord, but I was sick of your mama being mean to me and doing it when you turn around doing stuff. I'm going around. She was like, I was like, Tevin. You was like, what? And she was like, yes, son. I was like,
I see. Now you scandalizing her name.
Hey, I tell her that, and she tried to laugh and play it off. Oh, she knows. She was giving me the business. Yeah. But that's just like when she was a principal, they told her, they said either people loved her or they hate her. She had one or two. It was not both. She had no middle ground. They love her. She was the best principal ever, or they couldn't stand her. Yeah, because she got that no nonsense.
Yeah, the topic tonight is what, sweetheart?
You can at least have a topic.
Topic is in-laws and why we love them so much.
No, that's not
why. Why they're awesome. Not quite.
What's Cheryl saying?
That was it. They asked
something. No, so Cheryl said something right there. Oh. You know, that's delayed. Baby, hit the button right now. It takes it to the end.
I had the best mom-in-law, and I decided this how I would be with my daughters-in-law. Okay, so she had a good example.
Well, that's good. That's very good.
No, I had this one marked with this one says, what if your mother-in-law calls your wife and tells her that she needs to leave you because you're no good? Although I did make an outside child, but I'm trying to do better.
Well, see, that means that she really loves your daughter, your wife, and she feel like she can do better than you. And she probably was right. An outside baby, he wouldn't be with me no way. But, you know.
Well, he said he's doing better.
So. Yeah, ain't no better. You have an outside baby, ain't no better. Everybody got their strengths and weaknesses. That's mine. I know. Listen.
He made a mistake.
Jesus loves the children.
He fell in the coochie. Oh.
Did he say he tripped and fell in the coochie?
Oh. What's this? It's amazing.
Okay. Yeah, so. Oops. That being said, you know, that's the thing, too. If you have a real mother that is 100, she will not just take your side when things happen or, you know, like that situation.
See, one say he did trip. I told you that he fell.
Well, you ain't tripping, fell or nothing. You said bust it wide open, and she did. I'm saying. You couldn't strap it up or nothing. You got to bring the child home too. Cause now every time I see this child, I gotta think about you. And her. And doing that.
Hey, you trip. It happens.
Ooh. Yeah, one. God know who to get that to. Cause right now, baby.
Jay says, what if your mom-in-law thinks your son does no wrong and will not pull his coattail when she knows he's a mess? Or is it her place? If it's your son and it's your job to straighten.
Wait. It said my Lord knows your son. No, I think she's saying she know her son's a mess. And now, my mother-in-law loves me now, but let me tell you something. I remember when, honey, she wouldn't tell me if he had a letter come to the house because he had to give her permission. And she still got that ride or die for him. Don't get it twisted. That's what her loyalty is right here. See that right here?
Her son, yeah, that's what she meant. So, yeah, she meant her husband.
Well, I know, and my mother-in-law still have that,
That what?
She your ride or die.
Oh, yeah. Your mom is, too.
No, but my mom ain't. If I'm doing dirt, she ain't finna be telling me that's cool. Your mama, on the other hand,
still giving you dude's phone number. Stop.
Did you say give me dude's phone number?
Yeah.
He's telling, not telling the
truth. That's cool. You let me text you the number. You want to catch up?
He's making that up. Although his mother did that stuff, but he's making that up.
No, she ain't never did that.
Mm-hmm. All right. So, we are, if you have any more questions or statements, we are coming to the end, the near close, by like 5 minutes for the end of this broadcast. Remember, we put a post up on, if you guys are on Instagram, I did put a post up about the topic, but if you are on Facebook Live, I mean on Facebook, Find Black Love United, go to the events, like the events, share it, mm-hmm. Say you want to get notifications for our broadcast, because that's how we get you to know when we're going live, so you'll know when something is going on.
Devin, better late than never.
You real late, Devin. We about to
back and watch it though.
We get right. Ready to close in our last sermon. What does that say?
My in-laws just not telling me on Facebook, but didn't tell my husband that they didn't like me from day one because I am black and we've been together. I can't read the rest of that. What does that say? Been together 12 years, married 7. How am I supposed to react?
Okay, you gotta read the question out because people on
says my in-laws just now telling me on Facebook, but didn't tell my husband that they didn't like me from day one because I am black, and we've been together 12 years, married for 7.
Are you white? I mean, is he white? Because you say because you're black, is he white? Cause when you do interracial dating, a lot of times there's
a racial component
that takes a while to get over, cause it's not your norm, it's not what you were raised in the house with, yeah. And you know, as black families, we were raised if they can't use your comb, don't bring it home type theory, and of course that's not necessarily the truth, but that's the stuff that you know, especially like my parents, our parents are older, so. They went through a lot of racial stuff when it was really bad. So it doesn't, they don't necessarily discriminate, but it's just something different that they didn't, that was not the normal. Right. So it takes a little while to get rid of. But hey, if my mother-in-law didn't like me either, I'm black. And I knew it though. She didn't tell me, but she threw shade, so I knew it. But as long as you're better now.
She asked, can you put events on Instagram?
I don't know how to put events on Instagram. I mean, I could put a post and say we got something coming live, I guess. But I don't, you know, Instagram doesn't give you options except for to put a picture. So that's where it limits you. But listen, also go to YouTube and follow, subscribe to iEvents at Black Love United. We had a bunch of events I posted up. Subscribe. We want to get our YouTube followers up because there's a way we can go live from YouTube, which is much better. But I got to get my followers to get over there because everybody's on Facebook. But I will, T Bear, try to put events on YouTube. I mean, on
Instagram,
on Instagram. The word Insta, my husband.
Facebook.
What is that comment?
I know the feeling because my mother-in-law was something serious, but God is awesome. Now we are like mother and daughter.
And so that's the thing. Like, I mean, you know, the issue was originally, I think you said because you were black and he was white. But, I mean, I'm black, she blacker, and she ain't like me, and now we good. So, prayer change things all colors. So, you know, it's not just, you know, not like I say, the racial component does play a part.
Right. That just adds some additional time and additional layer to.
Oh, it adds additional a lot of stuff, not just time and layer. Oh, yes. Especially when they call your children nigger babies. But that's a whole other topic. I digress.
Yes. That's another day, another time.
So, please share. Please like. Please follow. We are logging off. I, you know, had surgery on December 20th and haven't even made a good month yet. So, but I'm trying to bounce back with working and everything else. So, and then, like I said, pray for Orlando. We have a murderer on the loose. He has killed his pregnant ex-girlfriend. He shot her brother. He shot a black police officer today who just celebrated her 1-year anniversary. And then another officer was shot and killed I'm not trying to kill, was killed in a motorcycle accident as a trying to do this trying to find locate him. They don't know where he is, but he's just armed and dangerous, and he's just, he has nothing to lose. So there's so many people in danger until we get that together. But on a side note, I definitely would say that, you know, make sure that you realize that tomorrow's not promised. Every time your spouse and children walk out the door, then you need to, you know, make sure that when they leave out, you're not saying, you know, I can't stand you, I wish you were never here, saying stuff other than uplifting and encouraging, because it may be your last time. You don't know. And coulda, shoulda, woulda, or if you just think about, if what I'm getting ready to say is the last thing they're going to hear from me, will I be able to live with that? Right. It will change your perspective.
Right. Everyone, we need to have an attitude of gratitude. Let's not take our spouses or anything else for granted. Like, my wife and I are trying to do this year. We're trying to live in the moment. We're trying to take everything in, be appreciative and grateful for everything.
I actually think we're going to do next week, we'll be living the moment, because I think it's important. Social media has damaged a lot of relationships. A lot of marriages have been, it used to just say irreconcilable differences when you did divorcing, but now it says, you know, social media. Right. People have infidelity and all kind of stuff with social media and
inboxing
and just DMs, different things. So I'm just going to say, and Instagram Live will be going off in 1 minute and 37 seconds because they give you exactly an hour. So thank you so much, Cher. And I will try to post, but I'll try to post all the videos as well onto our YouTube. So like our YouTube page, please, Black Love United. But when it says $60 reward, I said if I knew what he was, I should tell it. But I would tell it anyway, because the girl that he shot is a friend of mine, daughter, and killed. And you just got to think about if it's you. And we talk a lot about police brutality and how they mistreat us and how we, you know, we were getting shot just crazy last year. But it wasn't that we want you to go kill police officers. That's never the moat. That's never the thing. Because it's just like they say, one rotten apple can spoil the bunch. Right. It's so true. Like, there's a lot of good officers out there, but you got a handful that are just the devil. And they mess it up everybody else. That's just like, you know, how you can have good children, but you can have, you know, like at schools, you can have a classroom full of good children, but you got two or three that just make it help everybody else. Where the teacher can't do certain things they want to do because of, you know, the behavior. So, you know, hug your family, love your family, mm-hmm. and realize that tomorrow's not promised. Anything you want to say, baby?
I'm hungry.
Did I have anything to do with the broadcast? Mm-hmm. Well, we're not going outside because Cujo out there trying to shoot people. Mm-hmm. Hide your kids, hide your wife. All right, guys. Well, we're going to call it a night. And we thank you very much for following. Like I said, please go subscribe to this event. Because people always say, oh, I forgot or whatever. Share it to your page if you have not already shared it. We thank you so much for trusting us or spending your time with us and trusting us with your ear.
We don't take you for granted.
Marriage can work. It will work. And for a couple who thought that we could never make it,
never, ever.
Because the first 5 years, I wanted to kill him. Ten. And I wanted him to sleep. You said 10. The first 5 years.
9 3/4. Were awesomely bad.
But, guys, this is where we have a great relationship. We're able to help others.
It's
awesome. And we...
Really, babe?
And we have fun together, and I just appreciate his support even through these surgeries and stuff. It's just been great. And I mean, whoever thought that the marriage that we thought couldn't make it one more minute is the one that people say that gives them hope and inspiration. So when we see people like you couldn't have been through nothing worse than what we've been through, so, and you can make it. Thank you for supporting. Thanks for watching us tonight. Share. I appreciate tonight. What did I say?
Good night. First time viewing. Thanks.
Oh, wow. Well, shared, I guess. Well, Florence, if you get a minute, go back and look at, like, last week was amazing. We have some great topics, and we post something so people can put topics on. And this one's a little more serious because of it was talking about, you know, the balance of in-laws. I can't talk. So that's what happened. I'm hungry too, and I got to finish my meal. So, but I love you. Thank you guys for sharing and watching, and we will see you later.
Hey, keep us up in your prayers too. We need prayers. We need
pray that they find it.
Positivity. And also, we'll be back again, same bat time, same bat channel.
Next Monday is going to be great.
8 p.m. Eastern Standard, 9 p.m.
Living Central. In the moment. Get off your phones. Bye-bye. So I said, see you guys next week. Right, see you. Go subscribe to the event so you won't miss it.